Good morning, everybody, and welcome to JAM 2022. We're very glad that you're able to join us this morning. My name is Mike Winsman. I am the Director of Transfer and Technology. I am your MC for this event. I will be hosting the event over the course of the next 2 days. Also going to be presenting a couple of sessions both today as well as tomorrow. So you're going to see a lot of me. You're going to be pretty sick of me by the end of this event. So please just bear with me. I know it's going to be tough, but we'll try to get you through it. This is we're really glad to have you back. First and foremost, I just want to acknowledge that I am coming to you today from the unceded territory of the Coast Salish peoples, including the territories of the Musqueam, Squamish, and Tsleil-Waututh nations. BC CAT is committed to building respectful relationships with First Peoples, and we thank them for their hospitality. Tomorrow at the live event, we are pleased to welcome Hereditary Chief Gibby Jacob from the Squamish Nation, who will be offering opening reflections and a prayer. So we hope that you'll be able to join us for that. If you've attended JAM the last 2 years, this represents the third year where we are bringing a virtual component to JAM. And so we're really pleased that you can be here. We have over 300 people registered for this event coming to us from across British Columbia and a few from outside of British Columbia. I think that, you know, we'll all agree that the ongoing pandemic certainly hasn't been fun. But one of the great things about having JAM in this format is it enables people from across the province to connect, to share ideas on best practices in transfer and articulation. And for that, we're really grateful. We have a pretty diverse agenda for the next couple of days. You can go through the Whova app and take a look and see what we have on the menu. For the first time ever, we have a hybrid event. So we are really happy to be able to present to you tomorrow in human form. For those of you that are going to be attending the in-person event, it will be at the Pinnacle Harborfront Hotel in downtown Vancouver. We'll be kicking off tomorrow at 9:30, 9 o'clock, my mistake. It's 9 a.m. at the Pinnacle Hotel. And every event, every session will also be streamed online for those that are going to be joining us remotely. We're going to go into a little bit of a warm-up in just a second, but before I do that, what I'd like to do first now is introduce Jim Hamilton, who is BC CAT's Council Co-Chair, who is going to offer a few words on behalf of our event. So I'm going to pass it over to you, Jim.
Well, thanks, Mike. First of all, I want to issue a very warm welcome to everybody, to the speakers, the organizers, and all the participants. Thank you for participating in this year's JAM. As Mike mentioned a moment ago, today's audience includes people from the full scope of institutions that comprise BC CAT. And in addition, we're joined today by people from not just across BC, but as well as Alberta, Manitoba, and Ontario. And we welcome every one of you. I hope you all enjoy the opportunity to get together, to share your expertise, as well as to discuss important issues and best practices. My second message is to thank all of you and also those not present, but who also volunteer many hours of their time to assist the post-secondary students of British Columbia as they navigate their individual learning pathways from program to program and institution to institution. I always like to tell people a story that my experience with transfer goes back to the last century, actually, when I transferred from a BC institution to an unnamed institution in Ontario and lost a year in the process. So fortunately, students in British Columbia, thanks to the good work of BC CAT over the many years, have a much better prospect of gaining recognition for the learning they take from one institution to another. So after more than a decade of being involved at BC CAT, I continue to be impressed by the unstinting work of both the staff at BC CAT and the hundreds of colleagues from the sector without whom our system would not function. So however you are involved, you should feel proud of the way. So I get all choked up because I feel so strongly about it. I want to say, however you are involved, you should feel proud of the way you support student access, mobility, learning, and success. I am confident that we will continue to improve and adapt in order to sustain our fine post-secondary system and to serve the students who populate it. Finally, I thought I would end with a quick story because I always like to put a human face on the, Mike's great at telling how all the great numbers of all the things that the BC CAT does and how many transfer agreements there are and how many articulation committees there are and everything else. It's all very impressive and all very important. But I think every once in a while we have experiences that remind us of why we are here, why we do what we do. And I had one of those experiences a few weeks back when I was at an event that featured speeches from two alumni from the same university. One was a young woman who recently graduated from a Bachelor of Engineering in some kind of software engineering. And her educational pathway started at her local college, which just happened to be the college of which I was the president, probably at that time. Anyway, she started off at a local college, and then she sampled a couple of programs, and eventually she found the vocation that suited her and ended up in a seamless transfer to the university from which she ultimately graduated. Today, that young woman works in her chosen field and is giving back to the system that supported her by mentoring others who are pursuing science careers. The second speaker talked about her nearly two decades long journey to a degree in public administration. And she started out doing upgrading courses, curiously enough, at Okanagan College in Salmon Arm, and followed that with some transferable academic courses at that college and another post-secondary institution in the province, as well as Open University courses. And her path finally ended up in a degree in public administration. And today she holds a very responsible position. As different as these two stories are, they both testify to the value of a system that facilitates mobility, flexibility, and transfer, and does not impose unnecessary barriers to people who are finding their academic path. So I believe that that's something we can all feel very proud about. And I thank you all for your role in it. Please enjoy the conference today and tomorrow. Mike, it's back to you.
All right. Thank you, Jim. I really appreciate those kind words and I always appreciate your reflections and the work that you do in support of the council. So thanks again for being a part of our day. Moving on, I can see the chat is very active. Nice to see so many people already engaging through the platform. Really appreciate that. At this point, what I'd like to do is we have a prepared video from the Honorable Ann Kang, Minister of Advanced Education, Skills and Training. Minister Kang was unable to attend in person this year. However, she sent the following video remarks, and we're going to play them right now.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ann Kang, and I am the BC Minister of Advanced Education and Skills Training. I'm grateful to be sharing virtual greetings with you from the territory of the Lekwungen-speaking people, known as the Esquimalt and Songhees Nations, though I wish I could be there with you in person. I'd like to commend the BC Council on Admissions and Transfers for all your hard work this year. I'd also like to thank everyone in attendance, including those from other provinces. So much of this work is because of cross-province collaboration to establish and expand the number of transfer pathways into British Columbia for learners beginning their journey outside of this province. The COVID-19 pandemic has presented considerable challenges for post-secondary education and reinforced how crucial learner mobility is for successful outcomes. Students transfer for many different reasons: new personal opportunities, financial challenges, the ability to learn and live in a new and exciting environment, or changing events. Now more than ever, BC post-secondary students need flexible learning pathways that allow them to effectively pursue their studies. Due to the work of the BC Council on Admissions and Transfers, British Columbia's world-class transfer system enables students to move seamlessly between institutions and ensures more students can successfully pursue and complete their post-secondary education goals. without the flexible pathways and credit mobility of the BC transfer system. Students would not be able to participate and complete post-secondary studies as easily, and this would limit their abilities to thrive and to prosper in the face of the changing global economy. But that is not the case. With partners like BC Council on Admissions and Transfers, we are ensuring that students are future ready and helping them by removing barriers and making education and training more accessible, affordable, and relevant. Together, we can help businesses grow and prepare British Columbians for the jobs of tomorrow. Thank you all for the work you do to support students, past, present, and future. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Minister Kang. We appreciate you sending those remarks on behalf of the ministry, and we're appreciative of you being a part of our event, and we appreciate all the support that you've offered BCCAT. All right, we're gonna walk through a quick overview presentation of how this is all going to work. For those of you that are JAM veterans, this is probably gonna be old hat for all of you, but maybe you'll learn a few things. For those of you that are new to JAM, we're just gonna give you a bit of a lay of the land in terms of how things are gonna go to both today as well as tomorrow, and then let you know a little bit about how best to use the app. Now, obviously you're joining us online. You have already passed the first challenge. You have successfully logged into the event, whether it's online or through the mobile app. But there are a couple of things that you can do to get the most out of the app, and I'm going to go over give you a bit of an overview of how that all works. So first things first, you can either use the web app or the mobile app. You're not required to use the mobile app. We do find the web app seems to be a little bit more functional. We do recommend Chrome as the browser of choice. However, it does work on all browsers, but Chrome does seem to be the most stable. You can also use the mobile app, whether it's on an Apple device or an Android device. It's all available for free on the App Store. And I'll just say it up front, I don't have any stock in the company. I'm not trying to boost this software platform over anyone else. Just letting you know that it's free and it's available for you to use. Now, in terms of today's sessions, most of the event today will be a mixture of both live and pre-recorded. So most of the sessions are kept short. I know that because we've been doing online everything for the last 3 years now, it seems like we do have a lot of Zoom fatigue. And so we have built in a number of breaks and tried to keep sessions relatively brief and informative. And we find that that helps make things more lively for the audience. Now, we will be switching to a live component at the end of every session. So there'll be a pre-recording of the presentation. And then the people that have given the presentation will be on hand to switch over to live to answer your questions. So what that means is that we want you to make sure that you put your questions into the question and answer or the chat feature that's available within the platform, because that allows us to engage and work with the different presenters. Now, throughout the app, there are quite a few different features that allow you to see who is participating. As I mentioned, we have over 300 people registered for this event. So if you click on the app in the corner there, you should see the menu. And if you want to see who else is attending and make some connections, you can click on the attendees tab. This provides information on who's there. It allows you to get say hello. You can even create a virtual meetup if you'd like. And that gives you a sense of who else amongst your institution or amongst your transfer system colleagues is available today. In terms of the community, there are a number of different features that allow you to engage, and we would encourage you to post an icebreaker, post articles of interest on any of the message boards. There's lots of different opportunities. This is an opportunity to share. This is an opportunity to, you know, offer reflections, to share job postings. We do have a hashtag BCCATJAM2022. So if you're still on Twitter after this week's Elon Musk takeover, please feel free to tag us with the hashtag BCCATJAM2022. And that will get us onto on social media. We do are offering a SLAM JAM photo hunt. So SLAM stands for Sustainability, Learning, Access, and Mobility. It seemed like an obvious acronym. I can't believe it took us 3 years to finally come to it. But yes, this is the SLAM JAM photo hunt. We're asking for you to offer up any pictures that you'd like that represent those four pillars. Please be sure to add a caption to your image. We will be selecting three lucky winners to receive a prize pack. You have the ability to vote on your favorite pictures, and there's already quite a few pictures already up in the photo section. So please make sure you take a look and vote for your favorites. The deadline is 2 o'clock tomorrow, so you've got some time to think about this and upload a photo if you want to participate. And 2 p.m. is going to be the cutoff, and we'll be announcing the winners at the end of the event tomorrow afternoon. In terms of resources, if you click on the resources section on the left-hand side, if you're using a desktop app, you will be able to see all the different aspects of our event. You can find the question and answer that is part of every session. We will be uploading videos of today's sessions as well as tomorrow's sessions within the video gallery. We're also going to be putting them on our YouTube channel, which we'll be sending out links for. So if you can't attend every event today or have to step away, the sessions will be made available asynchronously for you to watch on your own time. And once again, there is our hashtag, which you can now use for Twitter. Now, health and safety is first and foremost. Now, being online, this is not so big of an issue, but for those of you that are coming tomorrow, we do want to encourage a respectful amount of distance and safe space. For you that are going to be attending in person, we encourage you to engage in the level that you feel comfortable. You know, the more you engage, whether it's through the platform or in person, the more we can engage with you. You can post your questions. Tomorrow's event will be a mask-friendly event. Masks are not required, but we will certainly encourage those who want to wear a mask are welcome to wear a mask. And if you have any problems or need any tech support, please feel free to email us at jam@bccat.ca. You can also contact our organizers through the platform, and we'll do our best to help you out in any way we can. All sound good? Are you guys ready for a bit of a warm-up? I hope so, because I'm going to give you a warm-up whether you like it or not. All right, so just to get things moving and just to get you a little bit acclimatized to the platform, I'm going to ask you to do a couple of things. Yes, I know I'm going to put you to work. I bet you thought that this is going to be one of those online conferences where you could put your feet up and just sit back and relax. Well, no, I am going to put you to work both today and tomorrow. So the first one's pretty easy, and I can already see that many of you have already started taking us up on this offer. The first thing I'd like you to do is to go into the chat and introduce yourself. To tell us who you are, tell us where you're coming from. If you'd like to acknowledge the unceded territories from which you are currently residing, please go ahead and put that into the chat. Now I'm going to let you in on a little bit of secret. This is going to be pulling back the veil a little bit on the production here. I'm actually about 10 to 15 seconds ahead of you on the stream. So I'm technically coming to you from the future. You are putting chats into it in the present. I will see them in the past. So we are playing with the space-time continuum today while we do our online jam. So if you put things into the chat, I will not see it immediately, and you won't be hearing my comments until about 15 seconds from now. But I'm glad to see so many people already taking us up on this. Hi, Maggie. Hi, Laura. Hi, Martha, Patricia, Tracy, Amber, Ashley. Boy, they're coming fast and furious. Thank you for taking part in the chat. This is a way for you to engage in a more informal way with your colleagues. And so nice to see it. I see that there's some weather issues for some of our people coming from the east as well as the north. Hopefully you don't get trapped by the big snowstorms. I hear there's a big rainstorm coming to Vancouver. So we're going to be dealing with a lot of it over the next few days. All right, that chat is hopping. Good to see. Thank you, everybody, for putting your introducing yourselves. Okay, I am going to move on to the next part of our warm-up. All right, and many of you have already taken advantage of this. So you'll notice in the chat whether you are, if you're on the web, you'll see it on the right-hand side. And if you are in a mobile device, you might see it on the bottom of your screen. But there should be a poll tab. And if you click on the poll, you will be able to see a very challenging question for your poll. So if you haven't answered the poll yet, please click on the poll and answer the question, is this the first time you're attending JAM? So that is an example of the type of polls that we're able to do. And we're going to be using some of those features later today. So please go ahead and answer the poll. Now, finally, I'm going to go over to the question and answer. So the Q&A is a little bit different than the chat. The chat's a little more informal. And we did find over the last couple of years that most people tend to put questions into the chat, but you can also put them into the question and answer, which gives it a little bit more structure and allows us to put bump questions up and down. So I am going to ask you now to go ahead and ask a thought-provoking question, and I'm going to do that as well. And you will see that coming to you in the future. This is a very important question. I have added a question in there. You have the ability to like a question. I see that there's a question in there. What are you hoping to take away from these 2 days of jam? I asked the question, what is for lunch? I see people are voting for that one. I don't know what is for lunch, but I saw that Rob Fleming, our executive director, brought in donuts from Tim Hortons. So that's always appreciated. We're going to carve it up at lunch. Feel free to, I see some replies are coming in. Tuna for Sarah Greenland's coffee. Yeah, Kelly, coffee is a absolute must for all of us. All right. Peanut butter sandwich, Karen. Okay, soup. All right, some healthier options there. That all sounds good. All right. I think you guys are getting the hang of it. I think you guys are going to do excellent on this platform. Why do I live in Toronto when Vancouver has ocean and mountains? That is an eternal question for everyone in Toronto. That's from Adrienne Galway. She's the new executive director for ONCAP, the Ontario Council on Articulation and Transfer. She's going to be joining us both online, obviously, and in person, and also be presenting tomorrow. So thanks for being a part of our day, Adrienne. All right. I think you guys are killing it. I think you guys are properly warmed up and ready. So I'm just going to thank you once again for being part of Jam 2022. We are going to take five, and we're going to come back at 10 a.m. with our first session, which is going to be on the Working Together, the Parts of the BC Transfer System. This is a session that's going to be led by my colleague, Dr. Fiona McQuarrie, and it provides a great overview of the key roles within our transfer system and how each role helps to keep the transfer system functioning effectively. I will just want to make one note for you. It's always best when you change sessions to leave the stream and then come back in the new session on the agenda. That just helps keeps the question and answers in order. Hopefully that isn't too complicated. You can always stay on the stream as well, and you will be able to see the next event. So with all that, I'll thank you once again for being here, and we will see you in about 5 minutes time at 10 a.m.